Hello and buongiorno. We are back with Hearts of Iron 4, and this time we are playing as Italy. Now, I've been rather attracted to Italy. It's, you know, kind of a major nation. Certainly not as strong as pretty much any of the others, pretty much, I guess. But there have been quite a few playthroughs as Italy, and, you know, I imagine most of them are pretty successful. Either they stay as fascist, or I think there's probably some who try going communist. But when I was watching some other videos, one commenter had said suggested that, you know, while a lot of people take democratic nations such as France or United Kingdom or most of the others, really, and then turn them fascist or communist, and then try to take over the world. How come you never see, or rarely see, people taking a fascist or communist nation and turning them democratic? Now, most people will complain that the democracies are boring to play, but I think really that's just true in the early part of the game, because you can't just declare wars and take over territory. So pretty much you're stuck with the first maybe couple of hours building up your territory. You can't even send volunteers or whatever. So, but I was curious about Italy, partly because I love their tank models. A lot of their tanks are rather interesting. And so I thought it would be an interesting can't think of a word, but experiment, I suppose, in because their focus tree is kind of fixed for a certain story or whatever, basically, and a lot of the original the original major nations kind of have this problem. If you're playing as Germany with their focus tree, really you can only go as, you know, a historical playthrough. You know, you have Rhineland, you I suppose you could befriend Czechoslovakia, but typically you take it over, and then you end up pretty much triggering World War II one way or the other. And so there is no way to play through the focus tree really as a democratic Germany, I think. And I think like France and Britain, France might be a little bit different because it might not. Yeah, it has. You can revise Versailles. They have the fascist or communist war than the status quo here. So as a democratic Italy, we're going to have some issues. Well, basically, we have the war in Ethiopia, and then basically we won't be able to side with Germany, because we won't be fascist. So we'll basically be going down Italy first and create our own faction, the Novus Imperium Romanum. But this is going to be a democratic Roman Empire, so we won't be able to, well, we could, but it would be silly for us to start a war with the UK or go after France. I don't think we'll be able to do treaty with Germany, or I suppose technically we could have military cooperation. But we're going to try to build a faction, and hopefully we can get, we'll have Bulgaria. Not sure if we'll go for Romania, because that might drag us into more of a war than we want. But we can try to befriend Greece, Yugoslavia, if we can grab them before they join the Allies. And so I think it'll be interesting to see how it goes. Germany might not like us and invade. And plus, even if it goes against Germany, In the later game, we still can declare war on the Soviet Union, most likely, because democracies can declare war on states that increase world tension. And if they send troops to Spain, that will count as increasing world tension. And as well, they might declare war on Poland or Iran or something or other. So I think it'll be an interesting playthrough. Another thing I should mention is that since we're taking Italy out of the Axis, that will naturally weaken Germany and the Axis as a whole. So part of the setup, I increased the bonuses to Germany, I think about by 25%. When you select a country, you can you ha there are sliders where you can select any of the major nations and set their relative power. So I increased Germany and I increased Japan because lately I've been noticing they've been kind of getting stomped on by the Allies. And since those two I increased, they might very well be too much of a match for the Soviet Union, so I increased the Soviet Union a little bit. Germany got increased the most because they're kind of on their own, facing down the bulk of the Allies. Japan increased a little bit just so they can maybe take over China a bit better, maybe work some more in Indonesia, or even fight against the Soviet Union a little bit better. But so we're going to hopefully have our hands full trying to defend democracy in the world. So let's get our stuff set out. We have four research slots, which is new, relatively new to me. I'm usually playing minor nations with only two or three. So we'll first get our equipment increased there. Now, I want to start working. I want to have large tank groups, but I think we can wait for that for now. We probably don't need much of a navy. Oh yeah, I think might want to improve our fighters. Okay, and grab electrical engineering and our production here. Okay, so we are at war with Ethiopia, but we have some factories we can develop here. So I'll start with a few civilian factories. And then a few military factories, and then a couple dockyards. Okay, so we have some here. We're mostly gonna just need a bunch of that. We're gonna increase that. So we said we wanted to work on tanks. See, so we still have a couple more. We're gonna need bombers and fighters. Okay, so this must be a variant of the other one. Okay. So we'll just keep those there for now. We definitely are running short on oil and other strategic resources. Oh, we still have a couple more, I guess, so just get those guns. Some dockyards. As I said, I don't think we probably have to worry about our navy, but just in case. Okay, so can't do triumph in Africa yet. There we go. So, yeah, let's get Ethiopian war logistics. No missions. Alright, no divisions. Basic training. So, I know we'll have to do a lot of mountain fighting, so I'll get some of those. That's just it for now. Okay, and we have a whole bunch of divisions. So, okay, we'll select these. Home Defense Force. Get a nice field marshal. Combat width. Yeah, we'll even put him in there. Okay, so we have our... African army. Wow, lots of ones. Ooh. Panzers. If we have... Okay, so we have a lot of ones. Old guard. Old guard. Lots of old guards, I guess. Oh well. You'll be stuck in Libya. Okay, and then we have our forces here. Now, I've kind of said before, I think, that this is a bit of a game where you have to set your own challenges. So, I know it's relatively common to just kind of throw more troops at the problem and just kind of, you know, and then have your conscription laws here deal with it. But I want to try to really husband my troops. I don't want to waste them really wantonly. So I want to try to play this and hopefully, like, I'd kind of figure it would be a loss if I'd have to go probably further than service by requirement, because I don't want to go to all adult served or even scraping the barrel. Now, we all are already at limited conscription, and so we're down to, you know, less than a million men, so this might be tough, but so I'm going to try to play this not as aggressively as one might. So I'm going to have this Mali Land Force. I'm going to group these up into pretty... oh wow, we have a lot of field marshals. They're all old guard though. Okay, stick you there. Put you on that border. So, I'm going to have to try to think more tactically this time than instead of just, you know, pushing aggressively and stuff. So, Eritrea. I don't know if that. EA? Eritrea? Yeah, EA. Expeditionary Force. Put you in there. So, gonna have him do there, and I'm going to have these guys special forward advance army. Give them a fancy name. They'll be my breakthrough troops. So, I like his mustache or beard combo. So, I'm not going to stretch these guys along the whole line. I'm just going to have them there. So, give these guys an offensive line just to push up there, but I'll have them on cost, you know, carefully advance. So, this is just if these guys withdraw, I can try to push up, but otherwise, I'm just going to leave them there. These guys are just going to sit on the border. Hopefully I'll have to wait for them to spread along there. And then these guys... Okay, I'll try to use this spearhead to push up there, because I don't want to trudge through the mountains here. I'm going to try to come along more of the coastline. Hopefully it's a little bit flatter. Okay, so we also have our air wings here. Give them all orders. And I'll even put them on low intensity. I don't want to lose more planes than I have to. Even though these are cheap old planes. Okay, so that's good. We have more planes back there. Oh, artillery. Oh, that's what we need. Artillery is going to be important. And I'll just reduce a couple here. There. Okay, so. Get this started. Just gonna wait for these guys. Hopefully they will. Okay, wait for them to move. Of course, naturally, it's gonna take a few hours. So, wait a couple days. And since we're hopefully entrenching, if the Ethiopians attack us, we'll be able to fight them off. Okay, we have a lot of our navies here. Commando Naval Sardinia. Sounds cool. So does it have destroyers? Okay, I want to split up the submarines. At least into a couple different navies. Sorry, Albania. Didn't mean to presume you were. Already Italy's. Okay, so these are all relatively major fleets. Except for you guys, so. Send you there. Alright, now, if I'm going to give these guys new troops, I'm gonna have to give them orders. So I'll just have you guys garrison up in there along the coast. They really wanna. Okay, and then these guys just garrison. Whoops. Just most of a garrison Rome. You know how easy it is to land at Rome. Okay, so how are our plans looking here? They're trying to attack there, so let's push in here. Have you convoy raiding? They don't have any ports, so it's kind of pointless, but. Okay, hopefully we'll be able to push through here before they do much down there. Could be up to another month, though. Come on, guys, just hold it. Might need a few more guys here. Okay. Guys are gonna go down there. Oh yeah, I have to tell them to get on the order. There we go. Okay. Almost pushed in here. Hopefully this will draw some pressure. And then these guys might spread out a bit more. Okay, there we go. Turn that battle around. You guys are moving into there. Hopefully we'll have somebody move in there. Okay, Ethian War logistics. So, we might have misjudged the logistics situation for our glorious conquest of Ethiopia. Must make it our primary goal to provide our brave troops with the necessary supplies. Okay, so let's also work. Now, an interesting thing, at least I kind of found, since a lot of our political stuff is locked away, we can work on developing our army right away. So, okay, so they are moving a guy there. Okay, that's... Okay, and we are moving more of our troops there. Okay, good. Okay, so they took that pretty well. So now, let's just do quick spearhead. I wonder if I can just hold Alt. Can I drag that there? Okay, good. And then change this. We don't need that. Okay, there we go. So, I could just, normally I would just, okay, go ahead, but I want them to build up the, their planning just so we don't lose any more troops than we have to. Now, see, I could make a plan for these guys. Push into here. Not across the river. So, yeah. Kind of a sucky plan. Guess I'll have to... There we go. Okay, but we finished our electronic engineering, which will certainly help. So, let's grab the computing to help our research just a little bit more. Okay, so now, looks like they're pretty much... Current fighting strength is only 64%. But they're confident. Division's still preparing. Okay, so we'll wait a little bit more. How about this? Well, I just gave them their plan, so... And they're just getting new reinforcements. Why are you going... Okay. Kind of silly. I think you'd want to... spread them out a bit more evenly. Pronto all'azione. Okay, but we can add these guys. What? Commandi. Say, oh. Why can't I? Oh, I did. Okay, never mind. Okay. Everybody's prepared. So let's go. Preparing. Still preparing. Winning, but it's going to take a while. Okay, and they're still trying to fight our defenses there. Okay, so, Nationalist Spain declared war on Spain. Spanish Civil War. Now, I have been trying to decide if I wanted to participate in this or not. There is this support nationalist Spain, but we have to have this one done already. Okay, so got army primacy. Industrial Italy is still lagging behind the decadent colonial empires. We must choose whether to prioritize the army or the navy. Choice seems obvious. Like the ancient Roman Empire depended on its legions, so must the new Italian Empire. Okay, so we can grab air innovations here. Or some more civilian factors would certainly be helpful. Because how many do we have? We have 16 right now. It is always nice when you get multiple full lines, just so you could, always goes much faster. So we are winning, but our numbers are going down. Okay, we got our basic machine tools and support weapons. Okay, so still in 36. We can grab. Oh, let's make sure we grab field hospitals. So that'll keep as many of our troops healthy as we can. So let's work on construction there. We got some more. Okay, I don't necessarily want to push there, but I have a feeling we can push in the north here, maybe. Okay. Alright, that's not going well, so we're going to stop our push there. Oh! Okay, so we want to turn democratic, so we're going to have to grab this guy early. So, I think hopefully this will be quicker. As I said, we want to turn democratic pretty much as soon as possible. So, we've almost won there. Okay, guys, come on. Oh, stop. There you go. Yeah, these troops really took a hammering. We're gonna have to work on. Oh, can't build anything there yet. Resupplying them. We'll have these guys keep holding. They are weaker than us. We'll wait till their strength dips a little bit more, I think. Yeah, see, the infrastructure is so bad, we can't get that very many troops in there. Okay, we'll try. Remember, do it carefully, guys. Okay, hopefully we'll be able to push that guy out. Win ratio 33%. Okay, but we only lost 2,500 troops, which I think is pretty good. Okay. Okay, so we got our better, modern aircraft here. And so let's start, I'm going to try to do this one. I'm going to assume that it's better at close support of armies. Oh, can change our airplane production here to the nice C-200 Saeta. How many are troops? Okay, we lost slightly more than 2,000. They've lost almost 40,000, so I'm happy with that. Okay, we'll probably push this guy out pretty quick. And you guys can stop. France and Britain announce alliance. This is pretty quick. Okay, we finished our industrial effort. Focus all our political efforts on building up the civilian industry in a great leap forward. So we get 4 more civilian factories. Let's grab this air innovations. Get even better aircraft. Leadership purges in the Soviet Union. Oh, did they just abandon that? Huh, okay. Hopefully we're winning that one.
Pronto, signore.
So, if they want to give us territory without fighting for it, I'm certainly, geez, who's moving in here? Who's attacking? Okay. Unfortunately, that allowed them to counterattack us, but... Shoot. Okay, stop that. Oh, games of the Olympiad, same as always. Let's see how our Spanish did. And like always, Nationalist Spain is winning. Oh well.
Pronto all'azione.
Oh, darn it.
Sì, signore.
Democratic opposition forming, so... Okay, so this we get... change in popularity of democratic, plus 10%. Also, slightly a bit of national unity, which is alright. Fine. Oh no, stop that. Darn it. I want you to have a small front line there. Okay, did they pull out? Or is that just a graphics glitch? Looks like they're trying to reinforce their... here, so we gotta try to save those guys before we lose any more. Oh, no, they came back. Well, might as... So, how many days? Another couple... Oh, no. Okay, wow. Really, throwing their troops in there. Looks like we might almost got Addis Ababa. Just have to walk in there. Okay, now, the typical thing is take all states, but I want to try to puppet them. There you go. Governorate of Ethiopia. So let's have a look at who's in charge here. Gima Selassie. Huh. Interesting. Okay. So, we have you guys. Stop your orders. Clear all your orders. And you can just sit on garrison duty. Smaller land. You guys.
Attento.
Probably take you guys. Turn you back to the Home Defense Force. And have you guys just... Yeah, that's fine. There you go.
Pronto.
Okay.
Ordini.
Now, you guys, I want you to... Oh, finished air invasions. Modern wars cannot be won without dominating the skies. We must do everything in our power to develop the Air Force. All right. Now we can do Triumph in Africa. We might still be able to grab that, demilitarization of the Rhineland. That's worrying, of course.
Formazione.
We got you guys. Oh, I didn't put you guys anywhere. You will go to Sicily. Darn it. First you will go to a port.
Avanzate.
Alright. Oh, we're done all of our training. Okay, well that's fine. What do we need? A whole lot of oil. Let's trade from Mexico.
Sì, signore.
Yeah. Waiting for that. Okay. Now, I'm not sure... Like, we probably want to wait till we flip before we get some of these, ideology guys. Trade deal opinion factor. I think that's probably pretty important. But, we only have one industrial or electronic. We can't even research electronic stuff. So, we might as well grab that. I probably should have grabbed the tank guy or the airplane guy since we seem to be making quite a bit of those. So, we lost 5,000 troops. Probably not the best, but I'd say that's pretty good. I'm curious to see, like, if you just told Evrida to march forward, what the losses would be. I'll have to try that sometime. Okay, so we're moving on. Nothing really to do, so I'll just crank it to max speed. As I said, there's not a whole lot of stuff we can really do. Okay. Get him to Sicily. Finished our construction. Now, again, I still like this efficiency retention and base, so I'm going to keep doing dispersed industry. I'm sorry, guys. Okay, finished mechanical computing and formation flying, alright. And field hospital, wow. So much stuff. Okay, so... Since I wanted to do a lot of mechanical forces, I think the mobile warfare is probably going to be the best bet for us. I'm kind of thinking instead of, 10,000 people in an infantry division, we'll have 5,000 people in a tank division who can hopefully fight better. Ooh, that's too much, even for me. So let's keep doing our... what are these? Doctrines! So... What else do we got here? Let's get synthetic oil. Because apparently we don't have very much oil. We can develop in Libya, but that'll be a while. Hey, finished Triumph in Africa. Failure in the first Italo-Ethiopian War has been a stain on Italian honor for 40 years. By achieving victory now, that stain will be removed, and the strength of the iron will of fascism will be proven. Okay. Now, I want to try to get this and support nationalist Spain, but unfortunately, I wasn't thinking ahead enough to send our troops over there already. So I'm just going to wait. We'll build up that. Okay, where do we got a couple tanks? I think we can only send two. So, send you guys. Put you in there. Spanish force. Okay, send volunteers. There we go. Okay, so we'll just have to wait till our troops get there. Hopefully, they aren't being sunk right there. How long will it be? 30th of December, so another week and a half. Do-do-do-do-do. Okay. Please don't give up yet, Republicans. I was tempted to fight on the Republican side, because when we turn Democratic, we'll be Republican Italy. So I figured a Republican Spain would be nice here. But since Mussolini is still in charge, we'll. Okay, we can do support nationalist Spain here. And see if we can. Where's our troops? To be in the same faction, huh? Oh well. Okay, hopefully this is just 30 days, so I'm sure the war will still be going, hopefully. How is our democracy doing? Getting up to 40%. I did find I had to wait till I was around 50 some percent, and then they actually asked for a referendum, which was nice. So I'm hoping by the end of 37 we should be a democracy. So almost got our support. I think once when I tried to play Italy before, I accidentally forgot about this and wasn't able to aim it. Okay, so. Spain is in the midst of a civil war, which will determine whether it will be a future possible fascist ally or remain a useless republic, or worse yet, fall to communism or anarchy. You must provide support to the true Spaniards before it is too late. Okay, so they really like us now. So now the Spanish Civil War has to be over. So let's continue our industrial effort. Oh, we could have sent three. Okay. Oh well. We'll just wait till the Spanish Civil War is over. See what Germany is up to. Anti-Comintern Pact. Okay. Oh, there's our tanks. There we go. Okay, we'll get another one on fighters. Okay, so now that this was another thing, because, okay, we're going to switch to democracy, but that doesn't necessarily mean we like the Comintern anymore. So I think I'll try joining it, all it'll mean is the Soviet Union doesn't like us as much, so we don't really care about the Soviets at this point, so put another one into... I only had one. Okay. But that's fine. I think we're actually... Spanish Civil War is over! End of the Spanish Civil War. So we'll be getting our tanks back. I don't know if we actually did much help. So as long as we have these bonuses, we might as well keep researching our doctrine there. So nice having 4 research slots off the start. So our troops are coming back. Yay! Now, I might actually just keep this guy around and move all of our tank divisions into there. Do we have... Oh, we only have 3. Okay, well, congratulations. With iron will and a relentless work ethic, we can mobilize the people in another great industrial effort. So we could actually grab another, our last research, or at least our 5th research slot. So, yeah, might as well. Okay, here, yeah, let's work on tank designer. We only have 1 choice, but it'll give us a bonus and a nice reliability upgrade, so... So I guess we need these guys. We can probably start building. Oh, we have to give an order to these guys first. You guys will patrol down here. There. So, Divisione Celere. We'll just make 7. Down there, and add it in. Is 7, right? Yeah, 7 divisions. Okay, now we're going to need a bunch more tanks, so... What does our tank division look like? Oh, jeez. We have horses? Come on, guys. Okay, so let's... There we go. So we're going to need more trucks. Hopefully we can research mechanized infantry, so we can switch those trucks to whatever half-tracks. Okay. Ah! Public call for elections! Interesting. Okay, political power gain, -50%, daily democracy support, plus 0.05. Now, this is an issue because as long as we have the focus going, we're actually losing, we're not gaining any political power. Base value of 2 is cut in half by protests, and so -1, we're getting 0. So, okay, so you're getting a lot of doctrine bonuses. Probably from our triumph in Africa. We've learned a lot. So I think I'll train just a... Oh, the Hindenburg goes down. I don't think we can't... Lots of things going on. Where's our Libyan troops? Here we go, North African. There we go. Okay, so the Japanese tried pushing at the Soviets, but they the Soviets withdrew, so Japanese might be probably also start increasing our... Because even if we're going to upgrade these, if we get more factories, you know, have a higher efficiency, because of our retention bonus that we got from dispersed industry, it won't drop as much when we switch. So, we got that. And it is 37, so let's grab that. So, how is our democracy now? Almost 45. I think it takes a couple years to switch our government. Hopefully we won't have to do a civil war. That would suck. Okay, direct ground support. We're out of that, so let's... we still have our bonus there. We get our research bonuses for bombers. So let's upgrade our ships, I guess. So what are... Oh, got our extras. So we could continue on, get some oil, actually, which would be nice. But, demand Balearic Islands. I want to try to grab this. Now, it is interesting. You'll see later on. I guess I might hold off on waiting there for that. So let's just hold off and build up our political power for now. Oh, but we got another... Oh, yeah. Okay, so let's start improving our artillery. All too often, I've been neglecting the artillery, and I think that just causes more losses when you don't have it. So, definitely going to try to make... Oh, but Amelia Earhart gets around, circumnavigates the globe. So unfortunately, the Hindenburg crashed, but Amelia Earhart makes it. Now, this is kind of another issue I've been having. Because I have to say, even if you turn off the historical tendencies, I can't remember exactly what they call it, 90% of the time, it still follows the historic track. It's like, I turn off the historic selection because I want to see different things happening, but it's always the same thing happening over again. Occasionally, maybe one or two countries change things, but... Oh well. So the Marco Polo Bridge incident. Like, I would like it if Japan actually puppets China once in a while. Or, like, as I said, Germany, a lot of the other ones, have their pretty historic routes fixed for them. They have to, you know, do the Anschluss, they have to go after Czechoslovakia. Bit of a problem with the focus trees, I think. Okay, so we got our synthetic oil advancements. We can make those refineries. I want to go back. It's not quite. We'll get radio. I still want to build radar installations. I don't know how helpful exactly they are, but... Oh, yeah. This one, France has to capitulate. So it's kind of a really limited stipulation. So, okay, we got our land doctrine. So let's grab our heavy tanks here, the P-75. So we already are almost at 48%. It's going to equal out pretty quick here. Not sure. I'll probably... Oh, material designer. Might go for motorized. Build up on Chinese border. Oh, and Poland's going for their Midzimordzi. Declared war on China. Finished all of our building. Alright. Chinese United Front forms. Okay, like always. So what can we build here? Oh, we can try building a couple refineries there. A couple more. What we got? Okay, so yeah. I don't know. like building things in threes. Okay, interwar artillery. Now, if we're fighting Germany or Russia, we're definitely going to need anti-tank weapons. So, grab that. Okay, we got our better dispersed industry. And excavation might help. I'm not even sure how much... I guess they have a fair amount of stuff. Could we get all that? This would basically get 50% extra. Certainly be interesting. Not anything in Libya yet. Okay, so let's grab... Oh! Debates democracy. Okay, so they're just saying, well, we'll allow it if they really want it. Okay, so let's grab the motorized equipment, because we definitely want... Oh, are we done all of our ships? Most of them. Of course, everything's kind of split up, I think, now. Okay! Democrats demand referendum. Okay, so we can either round them up, which would be kind of pointless. But comes the ruling party. Public elections will be held. So we lose some national unity. But I think it's good for all. Okay, there we go. We are Republican Italy. We had a nice... regular flag, and we got Carlo Orengo. Not sure if he's, Now, the interesting thing here... Okay, we can actually start this. I want to grab this, because... You see here... gains Italian diplomacy focus. Democratic influence. All of this used to be fascist influence. When we befriended these other countries. But now that they switched, it's democratic influence, which is certainly handy. But unfortunately, this one is still this same thing. Gains national spirit, fascist influence. So, and of course, we could try to wait and hope for France to fall. But I'm thinking... because this goes to democratic influence. That would be pretty interesting. But I think we might just demand the Balearic Islands. So, start that. Okay, we finished our tank divisions. Wow. Okay, we can rename this one. It's not the Spanish force anymore. Mobile response force. Okay, soldati class. Certainly good. Let's keep working. Now, there are two different cruisers. How do you look at the... Oh, yeah. Yeah, okay. So one takes twice as much manpower. One's a lot better. I wonder if one's more defensive. Fire range. This actually has shore bombardment. Naval firepower, anti-air. Yeesh. Okay, fire range 25, 19. Evasion. Evil firepower 8. Okay, so this is bigger guns, I guess. Max speed, same. Mac range, bigger range. More hit points. More armor. Okay, so this is like a light cruiser. We'll have the San Giorgio. Okay, what do we got? Oh, outdated equipment. What is that? Tanks? Oh! Oh, well. We don't need those old ships anyways. Okay, so what's Germany up to? Not much. But it is also interesting because none of these text changes. So it's all very aggressive and fascist writing. So it is kind of a... Duodecanese. Actually, that would be nice. Sicily and Sardinia. Because what I'm thinking is going down befriend Greece... and then claim on Turkey, so we can actually get a conquer focus against Turkey, even though we're democratic. Or we could go to war with Greece and befriend Turkey. Of course, Greece might be more likely to ask the Allies for help. But... has a lot more useful resources. Like, Turkey just mostly has a whole lot of chromium. And Greece has steel, chromium, tungsten, and aluminum. So I don't know. We'll have to keep that in mind. Because right now, I think they're both... neutral, so... okay, we got our radio. So, it is 38, so we'll just grab... I want to try to keep ahead in the electronic race. Hopefully we can keep an idea on what they're going. And if we get the decryption and encryption, it will help our give us bonus for our armies so that we don't lose as many troops. Which is certainly something that we're... looking for.
Si, signore.
Let me get you to do some exercises. Never know when a threat might because yeah, we have plenty of guns. We're all caught up on our production of guns. We get our tanks, anti-tank guns. Try to switch to. I think we can. When's the next gun? Oh, we'd have to research these. Wait till 1939 to get our. Well. Balearic Islands ceded to Republican Italy following the reliance on Italian forces in the Spanish Civil War. Alright, our two tank divisions totally turned the tide. Republican Italy has requested the Balearic Islands from nationalist Spain. Francisco Franco has acquiesced, highlighting the diplomatic move as strengthening of the bonds between the two nations. For Republican Italy, naval bases in the Balearic Islands will allow them to exert greater influence over the Strait of Gibraltar, give them better access to the Atlantic. Ha ha. So there we go. Having proven our support for Franco's new regime, we are in a position to request one of the important territories we fought to defend, the Balearic Islands, be ceded to Italy to strengthen our strategic hold of the Mediterranean. So, now we can head to befriend Yugoslavia. Now, interestingly enough, that will give us, give them democratic strength instead of fascist influence. So, okay, so these little islands are ours now. What do they have? A little airfield, small naval port, and one factory. What a diplomatic coup. Still think it probably would have been interesting if we could have Actually. Oh, wait. Do we still have... Oh, yeah, no. Because we switched to democracy, we lost the democratic protests. So we're back up to getting one a day. So let's actually boost democratic strength there. Maybe we might be able to switch them back to just regular Spain or whatever it'll be called in a democracy. So we got our heavy tank. Let's grab this. So then when we get a bonus for guns, we can use it for the kind of advanced, more advanced guns that we have to change, swap over our production lines for. Which will be good. How are you guys doing? Doing okay. I wonder if I should send the horses down to Libya.
Pronto, signore.
Okay, you guys can garrison Sicily. Oh wow, they actually... So often you get starting repeating colors. It would be nice if they actually... Well, I guess technically you could make any color out of that. But anyways, I think I'll end the first episode here. We successfully turned over to a democracy. But of course, we're not going to join the Allies. We are going to make our own faction and try to build a nice democratic Roman Empire. So I guess Roman Republic... I might have to have a look at what the Roman Republic was called, if not an imperium. But anyways, hopefully, so of course we won't be able to get Egypt or, you know, Syria. But hopefully we can build a coalition of nations and fight against the Axis and Comintern. So we'll have to see how things go in this world war. So I hope you enjoyed the episode, and I hope you'll join me for the next one. Thank you, and goodbye.